Welcome back to the channel. In the new series of video, I will cover prototype pollution topic, which is a new topic published by PortSwigger Web Security Academy. In the first part of the video, we'll cover what is prototype pollution, what is an object in JavaScript, and what is prototype in JavaScript. And after, I will go directly in the solution of the lab. So if you are interested in the solution of the lab, skip in the middle part of the video. Prototype pollution is a JavaScript vulnerability that enables an attacker to add arbitrary properties to global object prototypes, which might then be inherited by user-defined objects. Prototype pollution is often unexploitable as a standalone vulnerability. It lets an attacker control properties of objects that would otherwise be inaccessible. If the application subsequently handles an attacker control property in an unsafe way, this can potentially be chained with other vulnerabilities, most commonly .mixxx. We will see how to combine these two things in the lab. But for now, let's focus on what is a JavaScript object. A JavaScript object, as you can see here, is essentially just a collection of key value pairs known as properties. For example, we can take these properties and paste it here, and you can see that we are able to access through the dot or either with the brackets, but we need to add the annotation. And as you can see, we are able to access these two kind of things. Object prototype, what is it? Every object in JavaScript is linked to another object of some kind, known as prototype. By default, JavaScript automatically assigns new objects one of its build in global prototypes. I think this image could describe quite well what is going on. I will show you here a small demonstration. Once you create an object, it will inherit default type prototype provided by JavaScript. If we define a variable with an empty string, this variable will be with this function get prototype of, we'll have inherited the string prototype. But if we change the variable with a number, we will get the number prototype. Or if we change a variable with an array, we have the prototype of an array. So I want to show you also that if we define the user, because we can add properties in .char equals char, let's use this example. And if we redefine user and we add char as a property, but undefined, user will have char inherited from the object prototype. I think this could be enough to understand quite well what is going on. To find a source, we need to perform this kind of attack. One is this one. If it's not working, we can use this other one. Or we can go directly with DOM Invader, which is an extension available in Chromium. Chromium, you can load it from here. We will see this kind of solution at the end of the video. But right now we will go with a manual one just to understand what is going on. So this is the lab. We need to find the source that you can use to add arbitrary properties to the global object prototype. Identify a gadget property that allow you to execute arbitrary JavaScript and combine this to call the alert. Let's pass through PortSwigger community just to see the structure of the web application. But I will do most of the thing on Google Chrome. Let's change the filter. Now, let's add it to scope and let's clean this view, okay. Before we go through the resource, I want to show you just a few things. If we want to see what is the current object prototype, we can run object.prototype. And this is the object prototype at runtime. Now we can see if we are able to inject something with the DOM notation. Okay. We can use the brackets car dot car and see if we are able to inject it. I forgot the query parameter. So as you can see, we're still not able to inject it because I misspelled the attack. And now we are sure that we are able to inject the object prototype. We need to find the gadget. I already solved this lab, so I will go directly to the JavaScript file that will allow us to inject it. But two main files. This one is used by to split value from the URL, and the other one is the one that interests us the most because it has an object defined config which has this property transport URL. If it's available, it will be used to generate script dynamically into the web application. So we need to see if we are able to inject it. I will add the breakpoint here just to show you what is going on at runtime. And if we now add transport URL, we can here add the one value just for the demonstration. And you can see that the A will be passed into the transport tool. In fact, in the console, we can see that there will be a call to the script. So to solve this lab, we need to add the alert. We need to use this annotation. And as you can see, in this way, the alert will be passed as a value here in transport tool. And we will be able to solve the lab because the alert will be triggered normally. And maybe because the breakpoint is okay. And I want to show you also the solution here through the DOM invader. You can configure the DOM invader here, setting the DOM invader is on, and also on the attack types, you need to add prototype pollution is on. It will search for a gadget for a source, and once it finds something, it will trigger this red alert, and you can go to DOM invader, and in DOM invader you can exploit the sync. And it will try to perform various attack, and if we be able to attack, it will trigger the alert on the web browser. That's all for this video. See you in the next one.